course, was last night. Kaitlyn Farrington of the United States won gold on the halfpipe. Kelly Clark won bronze. They join us now in studio. Kaitlyn, I'll start with you. You got three gold medalists who are going to go after you in that final run. What are you thinking as you wait to see what their scores are?
I mean, for me, I was just so happy to land my second run and just kind of clean up my first run. And once I knew that I was on the podium, I was so happy with that. Like, I was celebrating just being an Olympic medalist, and then just to land on top and get the gold last night, I just can't believe it.
12 years ago, you won gold. And now, here you are winning bronze. How far has this sport come, Kelly?
That's the amazing thing about snowboarding, is that you're never going to be the best. It's always changing, it's always progressing, and to stay in it, you have to change and be challenged daily. I think that's why I still love it after 12 years of Olympic competition.
But you have to be proud to see this, though, what it was and what it is now, and you're still part of it.
It's amazing. It's an absolute privilege to know that I've had influence in a sport. I've helped it progress. I really hope that, you know, these women that come after me are going to be able to go further and take snowboarding further than I ever could.
Kaitlyn, explain how you got here with your parents. It's a pretty wild ride. You come from Idaho, small town, and they're selling livestock to get you to the Olympics?
Yeah, I mean, when I started out, it was kind of like, I loved snowboarding and just started competing with the Sun Valley Snowboard Team. And when I started doing better at contests and started going to bigger contests, to get there, my parents had to sell, we'd sell a cow every week just to get through that weekend of going wherever it was, Mount Snow or...
But you'd walk out and say which cow's going to be sold here?
Kind of like the cattle sale in Shoshone was every Wednesday, I think, or Thursday, and we'd load one up into the trailer, and my dad would take him to the cattle sale that day, and then that was my money for the snowboard contest.
How do you repay your parents?
You know, they sold all their cows, and now I don't think they're that sad about it because they're both here with me, and they are just having a blast. They're so excited. They were so excited to just be in Russia and get an experience of the Olympics, and then last night, I don't think my dad stopped crying all day, and he just burst into tears every now and again, so I think this is repaying them a little bit.
All the personalities you've seen through the years, Kel, there is camaraderie there. That it's not like country against country. It seemed like it was a collective group. Why is that?
Snowboarding is an interesting sport because it really has a culture behind it. And we really are individuals that are all out here trying to do our best. There's room for creativity. There's room for individuality in snowboarding. And that's what we all bring to the table. And that's what makes it so great that we all can go out and do our best runs. And that's what we want. We want everybody to go out there and perform their absolute best to see how we stack up against each other. And it's about those personal goals, and those friendships are stronger than those competitive things you find on competition day.
It was evident. Kaitlyn Farrington gold, Kelly Clark bronze. Good to see you. Thank you for coming by.
Thank you.
More live figure skating just ahead. The men's short program as the Sochi Games continue here on NBC SF.